Hey there boaters, Johan here from eBootsMotorin.tv. Today we're taking a closer look at the electric inboard motors with a power of 4 kilowatts. 4 kilowatts is ideal for boats weighing 2 to 4 tons, depending on the vessel and the specific area. We have motors from 12 companies in this power range, and we'll show you some differences as well as, of course, touch on the prices. First and foremost, it's important for us to give you a good sense of direction, to show you where the journey can lead. We're diving right into WaterWorld. WaterWorld is a company from the Netherlands, specializing primarily in controllers and control systems. There are quite a few advantages. Thanks to the low RPM, the often slightly larger diesel propeller can be reused and doesn't necessarily need to be replaced. That can even save you a few hundred euros. The display and throttle lever are already included in the price. Optional additional throttle levers and a second control station are possible. WaterWorld offers really comprehensive documentation and instructions. It's a straightforward plug-and-play setup with WaterWorld batteries included. And there's even dedicated map integration for iOS systems, as well as the flexibility to easily incorporate third-party batteries or seamlessly connect a Victron system. Otherwise, WaterWorld has no real downsides to speak of. In summary, it's a highly well-rounded package and stands as our top value for money recommendation. And also our best-selling brand. At the end of each engine, we take a look at the prices as well. First, we'll check the engine's standalone cost and its ride-ready price with accessories like the drive lever and mounting kit. Because some manufacturers still have hidden costs and we don't want to compare apples with oranges, you can always find this overview live on our website. I'll leave the link for you in the video description below. The price for the WaterWorld inboarder is 4,549 euros. With all relevant accessories, such as the mounting feet, it comes to 4,999 euros. In combination with a 5 kilowatt-hour lithium battery and a charger, you're looking at a total price starting from 6,799 euros. Electric inboard motors are especially quiet and maintenance-free. Here's a quick video of a WaterWorld installation from last year. If the old diesel breaks down now, an electric drive of up to 20, maybe 30 horsepower can already be cheaper than a new diesel, and the installation is also much, much simpler. Moving on to even more affordable inboards and those from the premium sector. At the end, we'll show you the setup of an inboard system and also share how you can save money during the conversion. So definitely stay until the end. It's important to note that, in the end, the differences really lie in the details. And it's also not that easy to verify. Ideally, we'd need to install all the motors in the same boat and test them, and that's obviously not so easily done. Next up, we have the manufacturer Aquamot from Austria. The advantage is that Aquamot motors are relatively affordable, and their own batteries can be connected to the very, very nice color display. Here, you pretty much have everything you need. The downside is that the efficiency of the motors is a bit lower, and unfortunately, there isn't very good or detailed documentation for the installation. Generally, we recommend always having the motors installed by a boat builder or the shipyard. In short, given the price, we often sell Aquamot. It's a reliable solution for leisure boats that rarely has issues post-installation. The Aquamot Trend 4.3 is 4,349 euros, accessories included from 4,700 euros, available for 99 euros, and starting from 6,599 euros with the battery, so it's a bit cheaper than the WaterWorld. Shark is a new brand developed with feedback from our customers. Shark is a solution for the more budget-conscious boater. The biggest advantage really lies in the price, which is significantly lower than all others. But how is this possible? The motor is produced for us by a European supplier. This company likely produces the most electric motors per month for all manufacturers and can offer an attractive price due to the high volume. It would only be cheaper with motors from China. Also, no large distribution network or appearances at trade shows are planned. Everything should go into ensuring high-quality motors, and the price should be kept as low as possible. Efficiency and torque are even slightly higher when compared to some other brands. Of course, there can't just be advantages. Shark omits elements like a display and CAN bus or NMH2000 interfaces to batteries or board systems. Many boaters have told us that they don't really need the display. With the batteries, you can always check the charge level and consumption on your phone via Bluetooth. That's usually enough for most people. If you absolutely want a display in the boat, you can always add a measuring device to get the data on consumption and range. You can save a few hundred euros by skipping the display. Also, the Shark brand is still quite new on the market. What I can say is that the engines are already being installed as standard in very, very well-known boats. We'll soon be showcasing a Shark motor project on YouTube, where we'll dive into the details and show you more. The Shark 4.0 alone costs 3,399 euros. With all the accessories, it comes to 3,999. Including the 5 kilowatt hour lithium battery, you're looking at a total price of 5,699 euros. VETUS is perhaps the best known manufacturer for inboards with over 20 years of experience. VETUS provides several benefits, including NMR 2000 or CAN bus integration. In addition to the air-cooled engines, there is also a water-cooled version and even one based on 24 volts, in case you already have compatible batteries on board. The motor is equipped with an active brake system, enabling rapid stops and delivering exceptional maneuverability in all situations. The documentation and manual are also very, very detailed and beautifully designed. Downside: the display and throttle lever feel a bit on the expensive side to me, which is why the previously mentioned systems are currently more popular among users. Conclusion? For water-cooled engines, VETUS is our top recommendation. It also integrates seamlessly into existing onboard electrical systems with ease. The VETUS 5 kilowatt costs 4,549 euros, but with accessories it comes to 5,599 euros. Including the battery, the total comes to 7,699 euros. E-Tech manufactures good permanent magnet motors in Poland with high efficiency and reliability. Downside, from our experience, there have occasionally been issues with the accessories, such as the water cooling, but never really with the motor itself. In conclusion, the motor from E-Tech has solid quality and is definitely a top contender when efficiency is a priority or when implementing a hybrid system. The E-Tech 4 kilowatt costs 6,499 euros, and including the battery, it comes in at 8,299 euros. Please remember, prices, availability, and technical specifications may vary depending on when you watch. Perhaps by then, we might even have a brand new model in our lineup. So if an electric drive is of interest to you, make sure to reach out to us beforehand. We can guide you in much greater depth and share valuable insights from both good and bad projects. The contact details are displayed here as always. We'll be in touch. COMBI is a well-known manufacturer from the Netherlands. Advantage: there are various special application fields. For example, multiple engines can be installed in series, and there are also special hybrid systems for existing larger engines. Fundamentally, the system from COMBI is really very smart, and the installation of the smart line is truly plug and play with just a few cables. Engines are available with either air or water cooling. In a nutshell, COMBI provides both classic applications and tailored solutions for individual boats. The COMBI 3.5 kilowatts costs 6,699 euros, and with the battery included, you're looking at 8,499 euros. In the next step, we'll summarize a few manufacturers. They are listed on our website, but some are still new to us, and with others, we simply have limited experience. But that's also because we primarily retrofit boats for private customers, and other manufacturers tend to focus more on commercial shipping. This includes, for example, RiPower and Aquawatt. These are manufacturers from Germany or Austria, which can also implement large customer projects and are primarily active locally. Furthermore, we also have Bellmarine and Kräutler, who are mainly active in commercial shipping. You might remember our trip to Amsterdam. We finished it by boarding a small passenger ship equipped with a Bellmarine engine. The manufacturer's prices are a bit higher than the ones mentioned earlier. There are definitely a few manufacturers out there that we don't even have on our website. For instance, Elco and Fischer Panda have developed a unique solution for extremely tight installation spaces, so it really depends on the specific setup and layout of your boat. We'll show you using a detailed overview of a boat which components are actually installed when switching to an electric inboard motor. Let's go from back to front. The propeller is located in front of the rudder and should be customized to the boat model and hull, as well as to the motor's RPM and torque. Often, the propeller can still be reused, but it also needs to be replaced regularly. If the propeller is too large, it generates too much heat and the engine can fail. make sure to have that checked. We're happy to do that for you. We work closely here with the propeller specialist grower, who can also supply the right propeller for you. The engine is mounted in the engine bay on a foundation with vibration dampers. The engine, including the controller, is then positioned directly in front of the shaft and connected securely to the shaft using a mounting flange of the appropriate size. It's important to precisely align the motor. Between the shaft and the motor, a flexible coupling may optionally be used as a galvanic isolation. Because if you're operating in salt water, for some motors like the Shark, it's not necessary because the motor is already fully anodized and won't have any corrosion issues. From the controller, a cable runs to the throttle and to the display. The motor is connected to the battery and the battery is linked to the charger. Alternatively, of course, solar or a generator can be used. The charger then ideally goes to an indoor outlet with an RCD safety switch and is connected to an outdoor socket, which is then charged at the marina or dock. The 12-volt circuit for onboard power and the 48-volt circuit for the propulsion battery are usually separate from each other. To be on the safe side, a galvanic isolator is also included in the system to prevent corrosion. In any case, I would include a main switch in the system to manually disconnect the electrical circuit. The greatest potential for savings, in my view, lies with the batteries. The manufacturer often has its own solution in the portfolio. Depending on the provider, it's 500 to 600 euros per kilowatt hour. Some may even have batteries at 1000 euros per kilowatt hour. We often recommend our own brand here for 300 euros per kilowatt hour. Ultimatron works with A-grade cells, offers a 5-year warranty, and has Bluetooth connectivity and an app. Through that, you can read all the important data and don't even necessarily need a separate display. Theoretically, you could find even cheaper batteries online, but those are usually not suitable for the boating area. Every now and then, someone installs a solar storage unit, for example, on a houseboat, but it's actually not suitable for damp areas. I would definitely advise against wiring with 4x12 volts or such DIY experiments with individual cells from Alibaba. There are simply too many potential sources of error here, and by now, the prices of batteries have dropped significantly. I hope the comparison was helpful. If you want to discuss specific motors again or need a quote, maybe you're still looking for a boat builder for the installation, then just contact us via email or phone. There's also a video coming soon where we accompanied the installation with a boat builder and shared our thoughts on the configuration with you. To make sure you don't miss it, definitely subscribe to our channel. We'll see you next time. Take care, your Johan.